Let's see the 2019 paper. English medium and single medium both are not clear, but we have to go through that. Right. Okay, let's see the first question. So I think I can have the paper. Okay, right now we can discuss with this, right? Right. Okay, now we can discuss this, right? Okay, we'll go through the paper. So that is very important, right? 2019 paper. Okay. Right, so
we can't see the screen.
Sorry, you can't see the page.
Yes, wait.
Yes. Can you see? Anybody cannot see the screen? Dinesh, can you see, Puta?
No, I can't.
You cannot. What about others?
We can see.
Huh? So only the Dinesh, you cannot see, Puta, again?
I'll try to relog, miss.
Sorry? Dinesh?
Miss Apo login about.
Ah, Hari. Okay. Right. Right. Okay. I share it. Right. Now we can go to that. Right. Okay. So this is our first question. I think this is the first day we have to discuss this. Which of the following device have both input and output capabilities? So that is very familiar questions with you. Right. Okay, so you can see joystick, OCR, touchscreen and webcam, right? Anybody can mark the answer. I want to check your answer. Yes, which of the following device have the both input and output capabilities? You know that touchscreen, that is very important, right? Joystick, that is input device and it is pointing device. OCR, that is optical character reader, right? Optical character reader. So you can you know OCR, optical character reader. So why we are using OCR? So there are some devices, special devices you can remember. What are they? OCR, next one. OCR and OMR. Can you remember optical mark reader, OMR? Next one. MICR, magnetic ink character read, MICR, right? So those are the devices that those devices are very important, right? Then you know OCR also one that is the device that is input device, right? OCR, can you remember OCR? Anybody can tell me OCR, optical character reader, why we are using OCR? Api OCR ke pavichchi karanne ay puthe. To get the normally to get the to OCR also scanner, right? It is also a scanner, but by normal scanner, you know. So this is the those are that picture. Normally this paper scanned by the normal scanner, right? But that's why I cannot edit this, right? But if I use the OCR, optical character reader, then I can take this picture as a document, right? Mama OCR එක පාවිච්චි කරලා නම් මම මේ paper එක scan කරේ පුතේ මට මේක characters විදියට text file එකක් විදියට තමයි එන්නේ. So that is very important, right? Then OCR used to scan the document and we can get that output as text file. Right, OCR එකෙන් අපිට ලැබෙන්නේ text file එකක්. එතකොට ඒක editable file එකක්. Normal scan එකකින් අපි දන්නවා flat bedded scanners තියෙන. එතකොට ඒ වගේ scan එකක් use කරොත් අපිට සාමාන්‍ය ලැබෙන්නේ picture type එකක් නේද? ඒකනේ දැන් අපි මේ පාවිච්චි කරන්න මේ පේන්නේ නැද්ද? හරියට scan කරලා නැහැ නේද පුතේ? Right, anyway, but we can get, we cannot edit and normal scanner normally we can get the picture, but by using the OCR you can get the text editable normally text file, right? OMR, can you remember OMR? That is optical mark reader. You know, if we have some institute normally use this OMR, there is a machine or we call that OMR. You know, there are some MCQ. When we use some MCQ, we have to use some special papers just like this, and we have to use HB pencil. Then, if it is MCQ one, so that answer is third one. So we by using the HB pencil, we have to color it, right? So we can feed this paper. We can feed this paper to OMR machine. It normally use the optical beam. To recognize the answer, ne? The OMR එකට අපි මේක දාපුවාම මොකද වෙන්නේ? ආලෝක කිරණ කදම්බයක් යා එකමතර පතිත කරනවා. ඕගොල්ලෝ දන්න black color කියන්නේ absorb කරන එකක්, totally absorbance එකක්. ඒ නිසා යා මොකද කරන්නේ? මෙතනින් අපෝ optical beams අපෝ reflect කරන්නේ නැහැ. But others are normally reflected, ne? There are some reflected light beams, but in this point there are no any reflected light beam. Then by using that point it recognize the answer. ඊට පස්සේ යාට දීලා තියෙන answers එක එක check කරලා බලලා මෙයාගේ හරි answers කොච්චරක් තියෙනවද කොච්චරක් වැරදිලා තියෙනවද කොච්චරක් reject වෙලා තියෙනවද කියලා එයා අන්තිමට stat වලින් දෙනවා. හරි. Then so that is very important that we call OMR, right? Why we are using MICR? මතකන කට්ටියත් ඇති මතක නැති කට්ටියත් ඇති magnetic ink character reader. Normally you know when we are using the check, right, you know there is a check number in this position, right? Normally me check number එක type me print වෙලා තියෙන පුතේ magnetized ink එකකින්. So when we use that MICR, that magnetic ink character reader, we can clarify this check, right? අපිට මේක يعني clarify කරගන්න නැත්නම් මේක check clearance එකක් කරගන්න පුළුවන්. මේක කාගේ කොහෙන්ද නිකුත් කරේ ඒ විස්තර ඔක්කොම ගන්න පුළුවන්. හරි. එතකොට මේ මෙන්න මේ check number එක read කරන්න තමයි පුතේ MICR එක use කරන්නේ. That is very important. ඔයගොල්ලෝ දැකලා තියෙන බෑන්ක් එකට ගිහලා check එකක් දුන්නා මේගොල්ලෝ check clearance කරන හැටි නේද? So that is very important, right? Okay, now those are very important, right? Those are the things about the OCR and some input devices. Then you know touch screen, that is input and it acts as input and output both, right? Touch screen, right? That is very important. And webcam, you know, webcam acts as a input device, right? So I have a webcam, that's why you can see me, right? So then my webcam acts as a input device. Okay. Now answer should be touch screen because touch screen act as a both input and output, right? Very good, right? Now second one, which of the following can be a good practice to protect data and information from computer hard disk failure, right? Right. ඔව් මොන හරි දැන් අපිට මොකද්ද මේ පාවිච්චි කරන්න ඕන අපේ data and information මොනවද ප්‍රොටෙක්ට් කරගන්න නේද මොනවද අපිට පාවිච්චි කරන්න පුළුවන් පුතේ yes very good install in the firewall right there are some soft firewalls and hard firewalls, right? So we can use both. ගොඩන්ට software විදිහට පාවිච්චි කරන්න පුළුවන් පොතේ එක hardware විදිහට පාවිච්චි කරන්න පුළුවන් firewalls, right? Normally firewall prevent unauthorized access, right? Firewall prevent unauthorized access, right? It prevent unauthorized access. අවසර නොලත් පුද්ගලයන්ගේ අවසර නොලත් පුද්ගලයන්ගේ පැමිණීම වළක්වන පුතේ firewall එකකින්. හරි. So this is internet. You know, cloud එක සාමාන්‍යයෙන් අපි cloud එකක් දාන internet වලට ඔන්න firewall is here, right? इंटरनेट थ्रू अभी मिशीन अनिवार्य ओन तर कटेट एंडवां रिमोट एक्सेस एंडवा बै यूसिंग दिस फायर वॉल यू नो दिस फायर वॉल बै यूसिंग दिस फायर वॉल वी कैन रिजेक्ट द अनऑथराइज्ड एक्सेस भले फैमिली में वाला पुलवा हरी बलमु which of the following then you know installing the firewall taking a periodic backups by using the periodic backups api kalinawa me amathara pitapat backups karana kene pita amathara pitada api puluwan cd ekata hari hard disk ekata hari dala ayin karanne eken apita puluwan oy virus avilla apita attack karoth apita we can protect by the viruses and all ne the ekeni hadisi hardware failures vela okoma machine eke nathi vela yanna puluwan so we can protect our data by using the by keeping the backups, right? Installing antivirus software so we can protect our files by from the viruses, and using the strong password. In this strong password, I use karam. Think godak elata think api unauthorized access it prevent karaganna puluwam. Edara metana han puthe so here they ask which of the following can be good practice to protect data and information from the hard disk failures? What should be the answer? Right? Right. What is the answer? Hmm? So can you mark your answer here? You can mark your answer, right? Then maybe the cutie color ni thiye ni, but mark karan man answer ke puti. Hare hard disk. Devin
yes miss
oh me screen ke pehne to gaya tha pute
oh miss
poddak in Biniti inna neda right
me screen sharing nathara una ay
na pute
screen sharing miss nathara karad miss naththam ekak
automatically ekak une pute api balamu apaw okay we'll go through that now can you see okay
yes,
now all ah, right okay right so I want the answer right you can mark this right you can mark the answer again can you mark the answer think about it right installing the firewall only that answer hey why what about the third one strong password nam puta we can refuse the unauthorized access no third one or first one first one normally you can prevent unauthorized access so what about the third one right yes very good third one is the answer no yes right third one should be the answer right because when you use the strong password you can prevent the unauthorized access right? You cannot prevent the hard disk failures, right? Yes, third one is the answer, right? Third one should be the answer. By using the firewall, you can prevent the unauthorized access and virus, antivirus guard. By using the antivirus guard, you can prevent the virus attacks for the softwares and all. But most probably, the, taking a periodic backups, that is good habit, right? To protect our files, right? So according to that, that third one should be the answer. Very good, right? Now we can move to the next one. Okay, right. Okay, now go to the next one. Which of the following is correct? This is third one, correct regarding the generations of computers, right? Integrated circuits were introduced in first generation computer. Which of them is correct, right? So you have to think about it, correct, and generations. ICs were introduced first generation. Is it yes? No. Oh, you know? Right. So look at here again. So so these are the something from your book, right? So you can remember that is this part from your grade 10 first lesson, end of the first lesson. You can remember harolwing hitagena wage balanna ne dani patta thibune anne eka thama mama anne patta harola apa hoganna deela thiyenne, right? So you can remember first generation, you, so what is the technology? Vacuum tubes. No, second generation, transistors. And you can see the languages, machine language and assembly languages, right? And those are the characteristic, right? Still, we didn't use the keyboard and mouse, right? And you can see the some examples about the, then what are the computers? ENIAC, EDBAC, EDSAC, UNIVAC. So those are the computers, right? Second generation transistors, right? And major technologies, transistors. Then you can see high level. Arrival of the high-level languages, that is the normally starting point, and use of assembly language, still using the assembly language, right? So look at here, smaller in size compared with this generation, right? Meyata sapeksha tamai poddak kuda vela thin, heat generation poddak adu vela ne, so that is very important, and low power consumption, comparatively faster. So you have to think about it, right? And you can see Honeywell 400 computer is a, and UNIVAC lab also one of the computer in second generation, right? Those are very important. Third generation, you can remember ICs, right? In a vacuum tubes, then after transistors, then after ICs, right? So those are very important. And birth of OS in third generation, you can remember, right? Those are the things you have to, especially you have to remember. Fourth generation, you can see LSIC, large scale, right? Very large scale integration, right? Then after only micro chips, right? So those are very important things. And OS with GUI, right? I thought I mentioned OS power take a command line interface again, but the DOS prompt again, the command line interface that is just like a black and white interface, but here colored interface. Normally we are using graphical user interface, nowadays we are using like that. So Unix OS, very small in size compared with this, and those are the example. So those are very important, Putta. So fifth generation ultra large scale integration, and you know artificial intelligence also for the fifth generation, and you have to remember some example for the fifth generation, and you know OS with the GUI, intent and email, voice recognition based systems that is based on AI, and character recognition, handwriting recognition, and you know nowadays we are using behavior recognition system, right? Ara bomba dana ena kattiya check karaganne yave e wage ewa thiyena neida, right? So there are so many things you had to think about here, right? Right, so this is the summary of the computer evolution: vacuum tubes, transistors, integrated circuits, fourth generation LSIC, VLSIC, microprocessor. Right, fifth generation, that is artificial intelligence and ULSIC, right? Okay, right. Now go to the third question, that is very important. So you know integrated circuits were introduced first generation, that is wrong, no? Yes. Vacuum tubes were introduced in second generation computers, right? Vacuum tubes, that is wrong, no? right? Transistors were introduced in third generation. Transistors in which generation? Put the number. Transistors. First, second, third. Patthakin uncle, yanna putte balanna. Transistors. Yeah, it is second generation. Very good. Very large scale integration. VLSI were introduced in fourth generation. Yes. Good. Very, that is the answer. So fourth one is the answer. You know, transistors in second generation. Vacuum tubes in first generation. ICs in which generation? Third generation. No. Right. So you have the answer. But answer is not important. We need the knowledge around this point. This question. Right. So that is very important. Right, maybe the atheetele musukal ethi samalata meva amathaka karala dala ethi, but you have to remember those things, right? Okay, now we can move to the next one, right? Which of the following are related to G to C, right? Can you remember those things? G to C, government to citizen, services in Sri Lanka, right? Weaving GCO, before that we have to go to through that point, right? You can remember the this is from the grade 10 again lesson number 1, right? Mathaka grade 10 karapu nathi daruwa thiyena nisa man poddak matak kala dennam putha. If they ask you some one of the question just like this, what is G to C, or give the standard form name for the G to C, so you cannot say government to citizen. That is wrong, right? If you say government to citizen, so in your textbook it is there, but no marks for that. If they ask you to define G to C, no marks if you write it as government to citizen. Ogolo sinhala medium daro G to C kiyana yanna ahadunna denna hari wage ahuwoth oya rajya saha purawasiyan kiyana eka liwoth lakunu binduway puthe naththan government to citizen kiyala liwoth lakunu binduway hari enan kohomada api liyanne putha. That is very important, right? Here we are talking about the electronic, that online concept, right? So therefore, so this is, we are talking about the ICT based method, right? That rajya ayilla puravasiyanta monawa hari aadhara laba denona. We cannot say that is not the government to citizen. Through the online, when they use the online or through the ICT, when they are given some services only, you can say G to C. That acronym comes from that, right? So therefore, what is that? You have to say govern the relationship in between, or the services through the so you can say ICT to the system. So you can say the services from the government to citizen, right? Through the ICT, the the services of the government to the citizens through the ICT. Without that, via the ICT, or through the ICT, or through the online, right? So you have to use those words. Otherwise, you cannot say it as G to C. Right, ogollo sinhala madhya daru kiyanna pote rajayak siya puravasiyanta antarjale osse laba dena sewawan kiyana eka thamai pote G to C kiyana acronym eken enne. The services from the government to the another government via the internet or through the internet or through the ICT, that we call G to C. Another one, the services from the government to the another business organization through the ICT, that's why we call G to B. Those are very important, right? The services from government to their employees through the internet, that's only we, in that case only we can say that is G to E service, right? Otherwise you cannot say G to E, right? Sevakiyanta wetuk denawa kiyala ewa kiyanna ba apita. අපිට එහෙම කියන්න නම් පුතේ අනිවාර්යෙන් through the internet or through the ICT කියන එක කියවෙන්නම අවශ්‍ය. Or web service, web based services also we can consider as ICT, right? What on through the web, එහෙම කියන්න පුළුවන් through the internet. It's okay, right? Okay. Now you can remember the services, right? No need to go through that, but look at here. Weaving GCE all your resources online. What is that? Online is there, right? So that is G to C, no? That is on, so you can see your result, right? I told you that that is your beautiful result. You can see after 1 year, about 1 year, right? You can see through the websites, right? So what is the website? dones.gov.lk, Department of Examination.gov.lk. So that is very important site. Ordering food items online. Ordering food items online, right? That is so that service from the one of the business organization, no? So therefore, ordering food items online, that is not the G2C service, but nowadays I think it is also sometimes, right? It's okay, but we cannot say it, right? Next one, renew the vehicle license. Vehicle, mother, I cannot see. Vehicle renew license online anyway, right? So that is also government to citizens, right? A and C only? Yes, very good. Your answer is correct, right? But we have to think about they are asking, they are considering the services of the e-government services. Can you remember what is e-government? Right? What is e-government? Gihindu, can you tell me what is e-government? Right? Gihindu? E-government? The services of the government via the internet for the for the other government, for the citizens, or for the organization, right? Can you remember those things, right? Those are very important, right? Okay, right. Okay, so you have to remember these things also, right? Okay, now we can go to the fifth one, right? Which of the following is an example for data processing, right? Again, this is also from the first or second, yeah, right? So, okay, calculating the account balancing using banking software after cash withdrawal. Data processing, right? You have to think of calculating account balance banking software after cash withdrawal. Right. Copying a file from a USB drive to the hard disk of the computer. That is not data processing. That is one of the process, but that is not the data processing, no? Installing sound editing software in the personal computer. No, that is also another process, but it is not the data processing. Yeah. Scanning a letter using this, using a scanner. No, that is also one of the process, but it is normally by using the input and output devices, we can do those things. But calculating the account balancing using the banking software after cash withdrawal, that is the real answer. Yes, right? So answer should be first one, right? Because we are using some data. So you have to think about the data. What are the data we have to use here, right? Making a hand pull on put make a data monomother. Process එක මොනවද output එක මොනවද කියලා ලියලා මට එවන්න හරි කියන වැඩ කෙරෙන්න ඕන පුතේ අනිවාර්යෙන් ලියලා එවන්න for this process right ඔය මේ data processing process එකේ තියෙන data මොනවද يعني input and after the process then you have to think about the processors then after outputs right so send it me right so that is very important okay now we can move to the next right okay this one is very important select the most suitable computer type from a supercomputer laptop and the tablet computer for the following application right now you have to think about the size and all right to process very large amount of data that are continuously obtained through the satellites right okay next one so process very large amount of data that are continuously obtained through. So which one is the most powerful computer type you know what is that you know that is supercomputer no yeah it's very good right supiri pariganake right and through the satellite then for a writer to work on an essay during a vacation away from home right poda gedirin æthata wenna indala neida ithin pahasin eha meha aran yanna puluwan deyak wennoni so and eroda yata properly peinnat ona neida screen ekak hondala thiyenna therefore we can use the laptop no hari api balamu puthe first ekak nam wennama bæne puthe neida writer essay writing walata api super computers ganna ne neida right first ekak nam wennama bæ putha hari right see for a traveling sales representative to enter the request while visiting shop ne the apu enathi shop yana yadi oy laptop ek usan gila eka kohen hari bare hinda patthekin tiyala the prashne ita wada api lesi mokadda by using the tablet computer for that process right e nisa so answer should be third one yes mokada etana ehttarama answer ek select wenawa eke edima hari टैबलेट के लैपटॉप के दिवात अपिट लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ डेटा भी प्रोसेस करने का नहीं नया पुते नहीं द देयरफॉर इट्स नॉर्मली विद द फर्स्ट आंसर वी कैन सिलेक्ट द थर्ड वन राइट बट वी हैव टू गो थ्रू द अदर पार्ट्स आल्सो राइट वेरी गुड राइट देन वी हैव ओनली 5 मिनट्स सो आई हैव टू गो टू द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट दैट इज सेवंथ वन राइट लुक एट द सेवंथ क्वेश्चन right seventh one again I have to go to the right okay look at here right now you can see seventh question right okay here this is our seventh question single medium daruwalanga man hitena paper ekak athi kiyala puthe awashya unoth api single medium ekak man metana thiyena api balamu okay next one consider following statement with the blank labeled a and b blanks labeled a and b when processing the cpu uses its then you have to think about here they have given the memories right you know primary memory mean that is ram ne the prathamika matakaya kiyanne puthe metana man kiyuwa meka it should be main memory hari api meegallo me pawichchi karanne primary memory kiyanne namuth eka man ogolange pothe haduwa meka main memory hari main memory kiyanne ram ekak gana hari and to temporarily store the data that the bought from ilangata api balamu mokadda wenne kiyala then process cpu users to temporarily store data that the that are brought from right what should be the answer cpu ek process kan pawichchi karanne mokadda pote kohinda pawichchi karanne monada kotana cpu ek tiyena memory ek mokadda so what is the memory inside the cpu ha cpu ek athule tiyena memory ek mokadda pote right cpu ek athule api dannawa you know that control unit this is control unit and ALU another one is ALU what is next one there is a small temporary memory small memory that we call register right that we call register right register okay register right this is the register right so you know and there is a RAM here that is RAM mean that is main memory not the primary memory so okay RAM so you can see here those are the input devices when we input some data it keep the RAM and it pass to process the CPU those data transfer to the CPU this is CPU right and you know here another small memory that is cache right then after processing we can see through the output devices that information right so that is very important so what should be the answer yes when processing the cpu uses its register right to temporarily store data that are brought from primary memory it should be second one so any problem with that yes answer should be second one right because cpu has memory chip that is register puta right normally it use the register when the when processing the cpu uses its small memory that we call register to temporarily store data that are brought from primary memory or this should be main memory but this they are using that primary memory now that's right so answer should be second one right single medium daruwanta mukut prashnaya thiyenada eke api balamu right? Only 2 minutes we have, right? මලම් පුතේගේ චුට්ටක් 7th one නේද? සිංහල මීඩියම් අයට ගැටලුවක් නැහැ නේද? Right. සැකසීම් කාර්ය කරන විට මධ්‍ය සැකසුම් ඒකකයේහි රෙජිස්ටර් භාවිත කරන්නේ ප්‍රාථමික මතකයේ නැත්නම් ප්‍රධාන මතකයෙන් ගෙන එන ලද తాවකාලික ආචායනය කිරීම සඳහාය. හරි පුතේ. ඒක හරි. සෙකන්ඩ් එක තමයි ඒකත්. හරි. Now we can go to the next one. 8th one. Right. Which of the following are correct regarding the regarding transmission media? UTP cables are suitable to transmit data for long distance over 200 meters. Already, when you need to put it because attenuation is very high. Right. I think I have to discuss with you a lot of things. Then I will have 40. Put the open eye. Give a chutta. Can you plan 30 when I come in? मोनाहारी काटहारी गटलून मट पोड दिन पोते මම පොඩ්ඩක් අර අහලා තියෙනවා රෑට ඕන මම එහෙමනොත් වීඩියෝ එක තමයි ගොන්න ෂෙයා කරන්න පුතේ ෂෙයා කළා මම